Hi, my name is Stan. I'm the product owner of Multilogin. Today we will talk how we can prepare your browser setup to successfully scale your Google and Facebook ad accounts. Today we will talk how such websites track you using so-called browser fingerprints. But before we dive deep into the technical details of how browser fingerprinting works, I would like to show you why the heck do you even need to know about browser fingerprinting. This is Swigrid. He is an affiliate marketer from India. In the past, he has been using virtual machine RDPs to securely manage his Facebook ad accounts. And the problems that he encountered was that his accounts would continue to get blocked a lot, and it was very difficult to scale with virtual machines. After he learned about how different ad companies track user behavior and browser fingerprints, and when he learned about how to mask browser fingerprints, he was able to manage more than 10x more accounts than before. And now he and his team are making close to 1 million yearly revenue. And the thing is that by knowing all the nitty-gritty and understanding how browser fingerprinting works will allow you and help you to scale your ad accounts more quickly and more efficiently. So the secret is browser fingerprinting. And before we begin, I would like to quickly explain what browser fingerprinting is. Browser fingerprinting is simply the data any website can collect about you. They can collect information about your location, information about your browser or your device. And using this data, websites can link accounts together or find different irregularities or problems in your browser setup. For example, they can detect that you're using a virtual machine or browsers that have altered browser fingerprints. Now, in theory, there is over 100 browser fingerprints available for the website to track. And each and one of these browser fingerprints reveal some information about you. However, the good news for you is that you don't need to know about all of them. You just need to understand a handful of them to successfully scale your Google and Facebook ad accounts. One of the most crucial browser fingerprints is the IP address. IP address can reveal a lot of information about you. It can reveal your location and it can reveal information about your internet service provider. When you're adding new advertising accounts, each new account should have a unique IP address. That is an ideal scenario that you should strive for. And to do that, you would need to use proxies. Proxies are simply solutions that allow you to mask your IP address for different accounts. Now, there's also different kinds of proxies. There's residential ones and data center ones. Residential proxies are IPs which belong to a normal residential network. So for example, an IP address that you use at home, and data center IPs belong to data centers. Obviously, if you're using data center IPs, websites will trust you less. And in the advertising world, data center proxies no longer work. The only proxies that work with advertising accounts are residential proxies. And there's a handful of different services that can provide you with residential proxies. These are like Luminati, Oxylabs, GeoSurf, and AirSocks. Mobile proxies are also an excellent solution. They are relatively easier to obtain than residential proxies. They are also cheaper for you, and they provide almost the same high quality as the residential IP addresses. Speaking of mobile IPs, there is also, if you don't want to spend a lot of money on proxies, you can simply use a modem dongle, and you can switch and change internet with it after each time you log in into your advertising account. Some people go into extremes and set up hubs of different mobile sticks, as you can see on this picture. During the past 3 years, the more technical part of the affiliate community has been obsessed with masking canvas and font fingerprinting. To give a quick explanation, simply canvas is how a fingerprint of how your browser renders an image, and fonts is simply a list of fonts installed on your machine. And affiliates were really obsessed with masking them. While at the time it was true, right now we have reasons to believe that this is no longer needed. And there are a few reasons why. One of the reasons is that essentially the website, what it wants to track those parameters which are stable over time. If the parameters change all the time, there is no need to track them because you cannot create any predictable models. As you may know, browser updates are being constantly rolled out by browser companies, and almost majority of all users update to it automatically. When a browser update comes out and the browser user is updated automatically, the browser fingerprint mechanic also changes, and it drastically affects how canvas and phone fingerprint perform. Hence, websites such as Facebook and Google, they do not have any incentive to track these parameters anymore. And actually, we have observed that Facebook has stopped enumerating fonts and using canvas fingerprint. For Google, we have observed that Google has stopped using font fingerprinting, but still continue to use canvas fingerprinting for checking different irregularities. So as an affiliate, if you're trying to scale your, let's say, account operations, you want to get access to more advertising accounts, then you may want to skip masking canvas and font fingerprint and leaving them as is, because websites most likely are not tracking them. So speaking about browser updates, since the majority of users update to their latest browser almost instantaneously, and the majority of users get updated automatically, it's always good to add new advertising accounts by using the recent browser version. Yeah, a more technical part of people listening to this presentation may ask, "Oh, what if I just change the user agent?" Well, in reality, yes, you can change the user agent. However, websites still will be able to determine your real browser core by checking for browser APIs. So as an affiliate, make sure that you're always creating or adding new advertising accounts from the latest browser version. Port scanning. Websites can scan your browser for open ports using a method called WebSockets. The thing is that with WebSockets, websites will be able to know what parallel programs you're running. And specifically, Facebook uses this algorithm to understand if you're running TeamViewer, AnyDesk, or any other remote connection program. On this picture, you can see on the right hand side, this is the code responsible for checking these ports. And as you can see, the port 6039 is TeamViewer 1. So as an affiliate, you would need a solution to mask these open ports, or you would need to bind TeamViewer or any other remote connection program to a non-default port. If you're just masking your IP address by using a proxy, then websites still will be able to understand your real location by checking for specific browser fingerprints that reveal your location. And these browser fingerprints are time zone, geolocation API, and WebRTC public IP leak. And important part is that this is one of the basic things you would definitely need to take into account if you're scaling your ad accounts. So if you're using a proxy, you will need to make sure that you include another solution that will mask these parameters and make the information about your IP address and these browser fingerprints consistent. WebGL fingerprint. WebGL has an enormous list of parameters that a website can discover. However, in our specific case, the only valuable parameters are unmasked vendor and unmasked renderer, as they reveal the video card of your machine. The thing is that as a normal user, you don't change your video card that often. I'm sure you don't do that as well. Maybe some of you do, but most of the people don't do it. And hence, websites really trust this parameter. It's a very stable parameter. It can reveal not only a lot of information about yourself, about your video card, it can also be used to check if whether you're using the operating system that you're claiming to use. For example, specific Mac OS systems do not have video cards that are typically installed on Windows. As an affiliate, the ideal video card is one that is both typical and popular. And yes, since this is a very stable parameter, websites will track this parameter and use it to uniquely identify you and check for consistency. So definitely make sure to keep your attention on this. Another browser fingerprint that is not really talked a lot is performance measurement. The idea behind performance measurement is that the website will ask the browser to perform a specific task, and then the website will measure how long it will take to accomplish such task. Then it can use this data, to better understand, better understand you as a user. And although it really cannot be really used to uniquely identify you in some way, it can be used to check whether you're opening the same profile from different PCs. This is why we always recommend affiliates to, if they're working in a team and if they're opening their accounts from different computers, to try and open them from the same devices, from the same operating systems, and from the same models. Here's a website. On this website, you can type a message, simply type two sentences, and then if you type this message from a different computer, from a different device, this website will be able to uniquely identify that it's you again. How it's possible is that when you type something on the internet, you have your own, typing pattern. You have your own typing biometric. And this reveals quite a lot of information about you. Amazing, isn't it? Now, we have observed that Facebook is tracking mouse movement and keyboard biometrics. We don't even need to give any proof for that, because actually Facebook simply openly admits that it's true. Facebook uses your keyboard biometric to uniquely identify you. However, we are quite sure that Facebook utilizes this method to understand whether you're using automation scripts inside Facebook. So automation tasks on Facebook, and if you are automating different tasks on Facebook, this can increase the risk scores of your ad accounts. Hence, using manual work is always better. Let's talk about trends. Let's talk about where the industry is going related to browser fingerprinting, and what can we expect in the future. In the past 2 years, affiliates would do a process so-called farm cookies before creating an account. And the reason to do this is that the website will see previous history and thus trust the browser more. The process would look something like that. You would open a fresh browser, go to different websites, and when you arrive eventually to the Facebook page, Facebook will see that you have previous history and hence will trust you more. While overall this trend is still a good idea for affiliates to utilize to increase their success rates of their ad accounts, the trend here is that this is shifting to a point where it might not be needed as much as it used to. The thing is that this year, Chrome released Chrome 80 version, and it became much more difficult for websites such as Facebook and Google to gather this cookie history. Hence, in the future, we might see some shift or change in the need of this cookie farming process. Facebook has also introduced limits on how many ads you can run simultaneously per page. If you spend less than 100,000 per year, then you can only run 250 active simultaneous ads. And this will go into effect in February 2021. Naturally, this trend shows that Facebook keep adding more and more limits to advertisers. So it's a good precaution for you as an affiliate to, let's say, have some ad accounts that are which are isolated from each other for risk diversification purposes, because you never know what will come up next. Another trend we see is that websites such as Facebook and Google, they try to focus on browser behavior analysis more than on browser fingerprints. And when I talk about user behavior, I mean when the ad account was created, where did the user log in from, what ads you're creating, and so on. And the main reason why such websites, they trust user behavioral data more than fingerprints, is simply that these websites already have a lot of data about user behavior, and it's very easy for them to use this data to create very predictable models of a normal, typical Facebook user. Furthermore, it's actually becoming more and more difficult to analyze browser fingerprints. As we talked today before, browser updates completely change. They change whenever a browser is updated, the browser fingerprint mechanic changes, and as a result, it's very difficult to trust some of the parameters. And another reason is actually users have learned to mask these parameters, and so Facebook and Google try to trust behavioral data more. As a result of all this change from user behavioral analysis, specifically affiliates, they move away from farming accounts into using existing real accounts to run ads. Around like 2 years ago, affiliates would farm accounts and create complicated processes to farm accounts more efficiently. However, due to the fact that Facebook and Google rely on behavioral data more and more, it's becoming more and more difficult right now. It simply takes too much time to farm an account. This is why affiliates start to use already existing accounts. They either rent them or ask from friends and family. And the reason why it works so well is that such accounts already have a ton of real good user behavioral data, which simply websites trust. So instead of using browser fingerprinting to uniquely identify the user, websites are shifting focus to using browser fingerprinting to check for different irregularities or problems in browser setup. For example, revealing that the IP is not consistent with the browser information, checking for that it's a virtual machine or not, and so on. It's interesting that when Multilogin has just started, everybody tried to mask as much as parameters as possible so accounts will not get linked. And the overall industry is changing a lot. It has changed a lot during the last 1-2 years since the browser updates are constantly being changed. And now for affiliates, the best best advice as we can say is that you should not think about changing all the parameters. You should think about how you can blend in the crowd, be more natural, have the latest browser version, have everything consistent, be as much as a normal user as you could be. I would like to end my talk today with a simple quote from one of our users, who's a successful affiliate, and he said that it's better to blend in the crowd than to be a purple cow. Thank you so much for listening to my presentation. Bye-bye.